Mohsen. Just a matter of minutes, first responders raced to Boulder High School, and within the next hour, several other schools placed on lockdown. By lunchtime, most were cleared, and then around 2 o'clock, another threat made in Littleton. And tonight, we're hearing there are even more districts than the ones you're seeing right here on your screen statewide. And tonight, we're learning all the calls made today appear to have been in alphabetical order by district, and law enforcement sources tell the problem solvers there's a possibility the calls came from overseas.
We have been keeping close tabs on those ongoing investigations. The FBI now getting involved as law enforcement work to try to trace those calls. We have live team coverage tonight from where this all started and how these incidents will be investigated. We begin now with Gabrielle Franklin. Gabrielle.
Yeah, Erica, well, the calls that led to these swatting incidents were just pranks, but for the parents, students, and law enforcement involved, they're not laughing at all.
CU Dispatch Center, their non-emergency dispatch center, received a 911 call at approximately 8:33 this morning. In the background, you can actually hear shots being fired. This prompted an emergency response by the Boulder Police Department.
But police say there was no actual emergency. Instead, it was one of dozens of swatting calls made across the Front Range today, targeting area schools.
I want to stress that I know how scary this is for the Boulder community, and especially the students and parents of the kids impacted by this type of call. I want to report that there are no injuries. Everyone is safe and out of the school at this time.
Boulder High School students ended up not coming back to school because of the incident. They weren't the only ones.
It was an announcement on the intercom. They said, this is a lockdown, this is not a drill. I think that's what they said. And we didn't hear them at first because we were in band and we were playing music.
Aiden is a freshman at Inglewood High. He says he and his band classmates were able to hide in a closet once they got word their school was on lockdown.
I didn't know what was happening, and it was definitely a scare. It was a huge scare, and I didn't expect it at all.
Parents were unsuspecting, too. Inglewood schools giving parents the option to pick up their students, many coming from work, after the false calls. And while Aiden is relieved no one was hurt today, he does have questions.
All these things keep happening, and I'm not sure I know why. I don't know. I don't know what the adults could do to stop it, but I do. I'm very glad that my band teacher, Mr. Malott, handled it so well. He was able to get us to safety really well, and he's able to calm us down.
And we also spoke to families who didn't necessarily want to speak on camera. They also expressed that same sentiment, that they're glad that everyone was okay, but they say that this hoax was an incredible waste of their time as well as community resources. Reporting live in Inglewood, Gabrielle Franklin, Fox 31. Yeah.